Good evening. I'm Annette Streeter, and this is Music and Taxes. Last month when we visited, I was talking about some of the changes in the European Union countries that have to do with the music industry. Today, I want to expand on that because we have a new change that is coming out, and it has to do with the, believe it or not, the way accounting and taxation is going to be audited and how it works on the financial statements. Let me give you just a little broad brush of how this has come about. The United States for years and years and years has been under what's called GAAP in accounting standards, generally accepted accounting procedures. And the European Union countries, when they joined forces in 2005, January 1, 2005, they adopted the international accounting standards so that all of the countries that are part of what we know as the EU were keeping their accounting and financial statements with the same regulations. Okay? The United States did not participate in that. We stayed with GAAP. This is one of the reasons why many of you who are in the music industry have talked with me and said, Annette, here's my royalty statements. Why is it I am not being paid on time when I have royalties coming from such and such areas? Why is it my music catalog valuation is not the same in Europe as it is in the United States? And I have to tell them, well, we have got some different business valuation standards. There are some different accounting standards. Now, time is changing. This is 2007, and we are about to merge these two standards within the next 18 months. Massive, massive procedure, because in the United States, the entire Internal Revenue Service system, the entire tax and accounting systems of all of the 50 states are going to have to be changed in part, maybe not entirety, but in part, so that the United States will now be part of the Global Accounting Standards, or the technical name, the International Accounting Standards. I have this up on the screen so that you can see. You can go to the internet. This is their active agenda. You can pull all of this up. I do want to scroll down to one area that is extremely important for those in the music industry. And here it is, right here. Intangible assets. I recently have ordered this book from the American Bar Association on intangible assets. I get a lot of publications from the Bar Association because they have a specialty area for the legal community and those who are interested or work in tandem with the legal community on intellectual property, entertainment field, broad range entertainment, including everything from sound recordings, movies, etc., live performances, the entire gamut of the entertainment industry, and sports. So when you take the intangible assets here and the legal definitions from the Bar Association of intangible assets, you find that they are inclusive of copyright, patents, trademarks, which is in part your logos. The copyrights are part of your value for the catalog that you may or you may sell during your lifetime, or may be passed on as an inheritance to your family in your music catalog. All of these things have a potential of having a tax and accounting change made to the way we interpret. I want to tell you that we have got two major newspapers that are covering this in detail. You want to check this on your internet. June the 1st was the Wall Street Journal announcement that, and they state toward the bottom here where I have it underlined for you, that the end of Gap is very near. We have another from another newspaper, which is from Seattle, Washington. Oh yes, the whole world is watching this one, and they're saying in part down here that this is the beginning of the end of Gap as we know it in the United States, and the beginning of regulations that will govern business and industry, accounting tax regulations, which will be one set of procedures throughout the world. These are called international accounting standards. For the music industry, this is outstanding. This is something that we have waited for in music industry for years and years. The phase in is the next 18 months. The tentative completion, and I do have to underline tentative because this is a major change in the United States. Lots of system changes. Tentative deadline on this would be the 1st of January 2009. Quite tentative. Some of the wording on this is the reconciliation of these two areas. There are many words that are describing what this process is going to be. You're serious about your catalog. If you are a member of any of the songwriting associations, we have many of them, or intellectual property associations, please make sure that your membership stays on top of this, and that the representatives of your associations, this is very serious, make your presence known as these meetings are going on in London. Make your presence known. Make your voices heard in this. This is an area you have wanted. You've complained that we needed change. The door is open now. You've got 18 months. Walk through it proudly, but get those changes made for the music industry. I'm Minette Streeter. This is Music and Taxes. Thank you for listening, and good night.